Hello, Oliver. Na, bir şey çok küçük.
These rocks have seen better days.
Ha!
I'm a wizard. Hey, noodles.
Hello, Gareth. I have those dried billywig stings.
You got them! Incredible.
Yeah, it is. Oh.
Happy to help. Here you go.
This is brilliant! Can't wait to get started. Thank you again. I'll let you know when I brewed my first batch of fizzing whiz beer.
Champion coming through. Hello, Lucan. Is the final round of Crossed Wands ready?
Look who's back. Ready to redeem yourself?
I certainly am.
Brilliant. Are you dealing with a partner?
Yes, Natty.
Then let's get started.
We can make this a real victory.
That's the spirit.
Wager.
one day I'll sign up for a round.
What a victory! You've won the tournament!
I'm just pleased to have done as well as I did.
And we're pleased to have such a gracious champion. Now, to the victor goes the prize! And so it is my great honor to present you with this simple yet elegant token of supreme dueling accomplishment.
Thank you. It's been an honor.
You earned it. You are a duelist to be reckoned with. Now that we've definitively crowned the tournament winner, I suppose I should get back to my schoolwork. Wonder how my herbology plants are doing. I haven't tended them in ages.
Have a cabbage.
Hey Jeff, how you doing? Hope you're feeling well.
Attention, fellow artists. Thank you.
And I hate swimming right now. What is going on there?
Why would I need a piece of toast? I suppose that's where it goes.
Hungry.
Could it be a visitor? The name's Richard Jackdaw. I was a student, just like you, about a century ago. How in the world did you find this place?
A house elf named Scrope sent me. Said I might find a black family ring here.
Ah. Sorry to say, I sold the ring a long time ago. Poor Scrope. Still holds a candle for Apollonia, I reckon. Can't say I blame him. I stole all these treasures just to impress her. Alas, 'twas to no avail. I thought a secret map I pilfered from Peeves would pique her interest. But she simply rolled her eyes. What would I want with yellowed old pages torn from a book? Not my finest moment.
I'd like to have those pages if you don't mind.
They're not here. I thought if Apollonia wasn't interested in the map on the pages, perhaps it would lead to something that would intrigue her. So, I followed the map. To what I can only describe as an enchanted cave of some kind. And you see what happened next? Here's an idea. Why don't you meet me at the edge of the Forbidden Forest, and I'll show you where to find the pages.
Why did I need the toast to get in here?
Oh, that was Apollonia's idea. Seems some squids love toast. They should have taught you that at Hogwarts.
How is it possible to steal from Peeves, a poltergeist?
I didn't steal the pages from his ghostly form. I merely found them in his wake of destruction. He has a penchant for wrecking things. Books, bottles, suits of armor. whatever's sure to cause the most chaos. He dropped them after a particularly aggressive romp through the library.
I think I can guess how you died, but who did it to you?
I was having a look around when I suddenly sensed a refreshing breeze. After that, I felt, well, light-headed. That's all I remember. Hence, if you do visit the cave, be prepared. I can't tell you what for specifically, but you seem a perceptive sort. Beware a light breeze.
I suppose if that's the only way for me to get those pages, I'll meet you at the forest.
I'm sure the pages are still tucked in my waistcoat. If you don't mind the sight of a, well, my decapitated skeleton, they're yours for the taking.
Revelio.
Two candles. Bridge. Lumos. Open forest. That in the background. Whatever that is.
A map. It doesn't appear to be connected to the missing pages. Best hang on to it for now.
Oh, I don't want to swim, so... We're gonna have to swim. Hold up.
Hello, Scrope. Thanks to you, I was able to enter Apollina's grotto. The toast was the key. I met a ghost there, Richard Jackdaw, who's agreed to lead me to the pages I've been looking for.
That boy was never good enough for Apollonia. Oh, what of the Black Family Ring?
I'm sorry to say that Jackdaw sold it long ago.
Sad news indeed. Scrope shall need to think of another way to impress the headmaster. Well, Scrope takes some consolation in knowing that the young Slytherin found what they needed.
I did. Thank you again, Scrope. You're a credit to House Elves.
Oh wow, this map is big.
Hmm. Elio. Incendio. Revelio.
No.
Revelio. Incendio. Levioso. Accio.
Doesn't work there. Hello. Hi.
This could prove dangerous.
Revelio.
Danger. I break Potch. That's a moth.
Incendio!
Didn't do anything. Didn't show anything.
Revelio! Let's see what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin.
Revelio.
What are you?
Yeah.
Levioso.
Revelio.
Somewhere. Did it go down there?
Accio.
I hope you're not stuck.
Incendio. Levioso. Accio. Revelio.
Floating candle. In Hogwarts? No. No, it's in Forbidden Forest. Oh, I walked a long way.
shortcut.
Spooky.
Here I am, as good as my word.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised to see you. It took the cunning of a Slytherin to track down these pages.
Well said. Now where do we go from here?
Follow me. I shall lead you as far as I can, but I fear I may remain a tad reluctant to revisit the scene of my demise. Keep your eyes open for a birdbath. When you find it, say intramuros. I think it's Latin, or Greek. As you can imagine, I never paid much attention in school. Shall we?
Aside from the bird bath, anything else I should look for?
Indeed. A few landmarks, a stone bridge, a waterfall, and, if I recall, a lake. You'll see.
You've been very helpful. Thank you.
Surprising how much of this is, rather unfortunately, coming back to me.
I'm getting nervous here.
Yes. You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it. Simply stick to the path and keep a sharp eye out for that birdbath. Adieu.
Is that Latin?
Or Greek?
Prepare to die, spiders!
Turn back. This. So let me reserve it.
Incendio. Keep going.
just get his zippity zoo out of there, I guess.
The waterfall. For a thief, Jackdaw's surprisingly as good as his word.
Are you trying to haunt me, Bucket?
Something oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags.
Dia!
There it is, just as Jackdaw described.
I don't see it. Is it here? What is it, this? Oh.
Intramuros.
Oh, Mark of the Chill Spines.
Aren't you a little far from home?
Renrock knew you'd eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding.
Can't.
No risk, those loyalists will report back to Ranrock now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me.
The tomb. Tomb of death. That's nice.
Revelio. I wonder how big this place is. Revelio.
Revelio.
shoot the symbol, but it doesn't stay lit for long.
Revelio.
I need to light all three before they time out on me.
Ew. Loading what?
Chris, that must be where this all leads. Someone didn't want casual visitors down here.
$11.
I wonder if any of my spells will help me through this.
Incendio!
Just do that.
Revelio.
Fang.
Revelio.
Perhaps the next symbol is hidden somewhere.
Revelio.
Was that not that one?
Revelio.
One mission pages. Yes, I'm gonna go in here. Bappy Baradi.
I'm not going to touch those.
Ew. Too many.
Revelio.
How many is there? One. Too many. Get fucked.
Incendio.
Ah, fuck.
Accio. Incendio. Revelio.
Yeah, that's how you know they do it.
Revelio.
Nice to see you. Come on.
Revelio.
Fuck off.
Revelio.
Don't do that again, please. That's just cool. No.
Revelio.
Okay. Just gonna kill them. Oh, come out of the hole. This way. I like this.
Not a heather skeleton in sight. but I may as well help myself to this. Good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there.
Am I going the wrong way? Oh, I'm dumb.
Revelio.
Touched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave.
Doesn't do anything.
Revelio.
Ish. No. Oh, I like my end then. Spooky. That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot. There's no sign of him.
Revelio.
Another spider, a dead spider.
Incendio!
Here.
glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be? Revelio. 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 Revelio.
Touched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave.
I'm a wizard!
Martini! I'm a wizard! Yes, I'm a wizard!
Wizard!
I just want to where's the thing?
Revelio.
There's so many chests. Why are there so many? Self fall and die. I'll just take the short round. Where is this place? A place where you shouldn't be looking. There's a bunch of spooders. Australian moment, am I right? What's the fucking thing? How do I get up there? Ah, mushrooms. Fucking mushrooms. There's no climbing thing.
Revelio.
Revelio.
Looks like a spell too.
Leviosa.
Have a cadaver in your own head. Oh no.
Okay, this all the way. I look horrifying. Goodness me.
Oof.
Quirky. Oh, really? I'm having a test tomorrow. Good luck with the test tomorrow. Jump. Oh, do not go without me.
That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
I gotta wear glasses. Oh, it's not too bad. It's not too bad. Oh, something else. No, no, I'm not gonna wear that.
Ha! Accio!
No, what did this do? I probably have to do nothing, but...
Revelio!
Revelio? $2, thank you. I mean, 2 coins, thank you very much. I'm supposed to be going over there, right? Right? What is this supposed to do?
There it is. The bridge. It's almost complete. More spiders.
These can't be what the heavy bridge is. Incendio!
Wrong spider, damn it. Every single one of them. Wrong button. Is he just shrinking? Martini, you gotta bleach your eyes. I'm sorry. Well, we'll start a voice track anyway. I don't know.
incendio.
Is this bug called potato? Oh yeah, you don't have bubble.
I can only imagine how these spiders have multiplied since Jackdaw came this way.
Look at that leg juice. What did he do over there? Oh, I should have done that wrong.
Revelio. I'll need to look around for the symbol. I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be?
Sorcery hat. I guess I'll die. Don't say that. Boing. 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 Boy. I'm not a fan of hats. I'll wear beanies. I like beanies.
I must be getting closer to Jackdaw's remains. And those pages. Revelio.
Oh dear.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Thank you for keeping these pages safe all these years.
Are you sure about that? I want those swords, actually.
Here it is. The map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room?
Revelio.
Take it. Incendio.
Ben. Starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this? I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of here. What is this place?
Oh, that's just a cool room. I like this room. Is this a boss fight? Not a shade.
Can it be?
Oh my. You're tall.
It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganach were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss, but first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
I'm a bit confused, sir. Why is this room called the Map Chamber?
I assure you that all will be clear once the book has been placed on the pedestal.
The statues and carvings in the house on the cliffside, those are of you. Are you a seer?
I am.
Did you know that I would be here?
I cannot say more at present, except to say that your presence here does not entirely surprise me.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
Challenge. Is that the Book of Requirements? No. Which one's better? I don't know which one's better. Avacadava? No. Oh, that's even better. Here's to the bomb. Damn. Oh, that's a good one.
I found the pages and the map chamber. Why would I need the book?
Am I under Hogwarts?
Revelio.
I'm back at Hogwarts. I wonder when Professor Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't neglect my studies while he was away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with till he returns with the book.
Something. Thank you, Yatu. Can you give that to me as a reminder in the DMs, please? That'd be great. I'm terrible at remembering things. God. I shall wear this. I'm a knight.
Should Nice. But the scarf. I'll just wear this.
You need to learn Depulso, the banishing charm, useful for pushing objects or adversaries away.
Revelio.
Tasks, and meet me in my classroom.
Professor Sharp.
Come now, Annabelle. It was a long time ago.
Yep, you see running night in the castle.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Wait a minute, where am I going again? Oh, what? Why do I have to take flying classes? I don't want flying classes. Me clanking along. This armor is so flexible. Hey. I'm you now. Don't mind me, I'm built different. I don't want to fly. Oh, I just sleep on the ground, okay.
Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started.
Yep.
Mr. Clopton, your attention, please.
Sorry, Madam Kagawa.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class.
Welcome.
That's me, the armor.
The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely. As broom flight is, first and foremost, a means of transportation.
This, I fear, some of you have forgotten.
Diving, rolling, and loop-the-loops will not be taught or in fact tolerated in this class. We'll leave that to professional Quidditch players. like the Toyohashi Tengu.
Boo.
Not a fan, I take it? Now, let's see how well everyone kept up with their practice over the summer holidays. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat. Up!
Thank you.
Now, your turn.
Up. Up, you stupid ratty school broom.
My hand.
Up.
There's something wrong with my
One
hand.
One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off.
Oh, I'm crying, dude.
Just shit on it.
I hope I'm not that heavy.
And if you hear my whistle while you're in flight, ground yourself at once. Good. Now, for your first lesson, fly through each ring in the courtyard. Do take care.
It'll take some getting
the brooms
used to.
Are school property. I want them returned in one piece.
I did it.
Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom, let's see how well you manage with a more advanced exercise, shall we?
Funky hedge. You are.
This next set of rings will take you around the grounds for more of a challenge.
What have you?
Hello. Nice day for a flight.
Ah, oh, the old boathouse. Wish you could have experienced crossing the lake as the first year. Whoa! Our aquatic resident likes to make an appearance once in a while.
That wasn't too bad.
Oh. I blame Joey. Happy Mother's Day to your mom. Cheers, Joey.
God, I'm terrible at flying.
Oh, well done! Have a moment?
I see. Say, I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We haven't properly met. I'm Everett Clopton. Am I right in suspecting that a Slytherin like you might be interested in making an escape from class?
Kagawa seems strict. I wouldn't want to get into trouble.
Kagawa won't even notice. Besides, a bird doesn't learn how to fly by staying in the nest. Follow me. The tour is about to begin. Follow closely now. Right now, we're flying over the Transfiguration Courtyard. Lovely as ever. Let's hope the headmaster isn't having tea by the window today.
Where are you going?
Nice to get above it all, isn't it?
I fucking hate flying.
Oh my god.
Ahead of the gardens. The Hufflepuff common room windows just peek out. Bit claustrophobic for my taste.
How is
as ever it flies.
Here's something handy to know. Lean forward for a burst of speed. Helpful if you need to escape a tricky situation.
Oh, too many to work. Get back, Can. I'm coming.
You sure you're not part hippogriff?
I'm coming to get you.
There's the famous bridge. Think of all the magic holding it up. I mean, look at it. And the owlery. That's a bit of solid architecture, isn't it?
Flying dibs and a jaunt around Hogwarts. This is quite the tour, Everett.
That's Kagawa's whistle. This concludes our tour. Let's hurry back. Better hurry and hand in our brooms. Dismount here.
I can't.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I am disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough! Class is finished for the day. As for you, you do well to use better judgment in the future.
Yes.
Chin up. That was some rather good flying.
Flexible armor.
Sorry about that business with Kagawa, but you have to admit those views were worth it.
Perhaps. But we did get in trouble, and Kagawa could hold it against us.
Rotten luck, that. I didn't think she'd see us. But it's no matter. You seem at home on a broom. Bet if you had a fancy model, you could fly laps around Imelda. She's Kagawa's favorite. I could show her a thing or two if I had my own broom. Hate having to return the school broom after class.
Perhaps I'll have to purchase a broom, then.
If you can, you should. Wish I could. I recommend visiting Albie Weeks at Spintwitch's in Hogsmeade. He's always looking to test new models. I'll keep an eye out for you in the sky.
I have a long sword. Did I not do this one? Oh no, who's up here? Where's the room though? I'll just go up here.
I've not forgotten about our library venture. How did you fare? If you're keen for some illicit spell practice, meet me outside the Defense Against the Dark Arts classroom. I know a discreet place near there.
Please meet me in the 7th floor corridor as soon as you can. I have an idea for somewhere you can focus on your studies, away from prying eyes and distractions.
Is it under? I believe it's under. It's under.
Professor Weasley?
Somewhere away from prying eyes.
Forgive me, the headmaster stopped me and I... Merlin's beard! I see you've wasted no time. Well done.
Shall we?
After you, Professor.
My hand isn't right. It's like wearing mitts. Hand mitts.
What is this place?
This is the Room of Requirement. It only appears when one is in real need of it. Ordinarily, a student might stumble upon this room entirely by accident. If ever. I'd only planned to suggest to you how to find it by walking past that bit of wall, focusing on what you need. But you've managed to reveal the room on your own. While I'm here, we should take advantage of the moment. Now, where is Deke? He must have sneaked past and gone ahead.
Deke, Professor?
The house elf I was speaking to in my classroom your first day. Thought he might help you use the room once you've found it. There's no chance I'm clambering over this mess. This presents the perfect opportunity to teach you Evanesco, the vanishing spell. You can cast Evanesco to vanish certain objects, such as these chairs and other things here in the room. I suggest you practice the wand movements first, then you can clear the chairs away. Splendid. Now, cast Evanesco on those chairs. Excellent work. You'll note that you are now in possession of Moonstone. We shall discuss its uses later. Let's move on. Where in Merlin's name is that elf? Is that... goodness. My old school bag. I wondered where that had got to. I can't believe it's still here. I'll just take a quick look at this. Give you an opportunity to explore on your own until we locate Deke.
Thank you.
Yes, Professor.
Dear me. Can't you keep it down?
Some of us are trying to rest. Revelio.
I'm drinking tea. Through my armor.
I hope this isn't as precarious as it looks.
An intruder! Stop them! No, not... that's not helpful, you worthless pile of tin!
I'm made out of tin. I'm a... Made by a tricky thing. Funny.
Revelio. How does anyone other than a house elf manage to get around in here? What was that? Is that a golden snitch?
Perhaps you should summon your wits and find out.
This should go on over. Probably. Things are full.
hope that house elf can find us in here.
Dobby, it's free!
Yikes, careful!
Huh? Oh, there you are. Wait right there. Deke will come to you. Hello.
Ah, Deke, we've been looking for you.
Apologies, Professor Weasley. Deke was looking through some of what's appeared in the room since Deke was last here. Is this the student?
Indeed it is.
Deke is honored to meet you.
Deke has been a friend since I was a second year. We discovered this room together. I mentioned you to Deke. We believe that you might be able to benefit from this room like I did. Deke, would you be so kind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. The Room of Requirement will always be equipped for the Seeker's needs. It's unplottable, so won't appear on any map. Most happen upon it by accident, if ever. Deke seen students in need of an extra file for potions stumble upon the room filled with them. You seem to have accessed it in its form as the Room of Hidden Things.
I was thinking about needing a place away from prying eyes. Brilliant.
Oh, that explains it then.
What I need specifically is a place where I can catch up on my schoolwork without distraction.
Well then, the room can provide you with precisely that. Now, it's time to focus on what you need. Just close your eyes. Imagine the room precisely as you need it. The room will do the rest.
You've given yourself quite a canvas to work with. I look forward to seeing what you do with the space. Ah, and it seems the room has provided you with a desk of description. Excellent. It can identify unfamiliar items of clothing. One should always understand the effects of anything in which one is clothed. You'll find plenty of items of clothing that need to be identified. The desk will be an invaluable resource.
I imagine the desk of description will come in handy.
It will. I hope you'll take advantage of it. Now, I'll give you a brief lesson in conjuring. The room might not provide everything you need on its own.
Conjuring?
Yes. The magic of creating or conjuring objects. I'll teach you. Very good. When conjuring more complex objects, you'll need what's called a spellcraft. Spellcrafts are like recipes. They list the ingredients or resources needed to conjure a particular object. You should have acquired some for a potion station and potting table from tomes and scrolls in Hogsmeade.
I did. Where can I find the resources I need?
While resources such as moonstone can be obtained throughout the Highlands, it's much safer and easier to purchase them. They can also be collected by vanishing objects in the room, such as the chairs you vanished earlier. In fact, you should have enough resources for now.
I see. Can I regain resources by vanishing something I've already conjured?
You can indeed. Quite perceptive. Why don't you give it a try? Go ahead and conjure the potion station and potting table. You should find both familiar, since they'll resemble the ones you've already used to study magical plants and brew potions in class.
How come you're in armor? I'm the chosen one. I served. I just went through gear. Change appearances. And you can choose whatever you want. There is something wrong with my hands. Okay, so what do I need to do? Potting table, potion station. I need to change.
Tango!
Okay, pudding. How do you rotate?
You can use these whenever you need to brew potions or grow plants. Presuming, of course, you've collected any seeds or potion ingredients you need in Hogsmeade or outside the castle grounds.
I want these. What's that? That looks cool. And that. I can do this.
will be here to answer any questions you may have. Do not underestimate his insights.
Can I use this type of transfiguration magic outside of the room?
Conjuring and vanishing are strictly forbidden elsewhere in the castle. We've charms in place to enforce that. It would be exhausting to reverse the errors in both judgment and magic. But the Room of Requirement has its own rules.
Can you tell me a bit more about Deke?
He's been at Hogwarts longer than I have, and seems to know its every nook, cranny, and secret. We discovered this room together when I was a student. Deke has had a good deal of experience, both here at Hogwarts and at a previous post. I shall let Deke tell you more when he's ready, but again, you would be wise to listen to any suggestions he may have.
I will be sure to speak with Deke if I need anything. Thank you.
Good luck. I shall linger a bit longer in case you'd like to learn another transfiguration spell for use in the room.
Hasn't seen this many plants here before. Deke thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed.
I'm ready for the next lesson, Professor.
Very well. First, you'll need to gather some moonstone. You can acquire it by vanishing items here in the Room of Requirement, or you can gather it carefully outside of the Hogwarts grounds. Return to me once you've gathered enough, and we shall begin the lesson. vanishing items here in the room, or you could gather it outside the Hogwarts grounds.
Nothing to identify, for now at least. I have the moonstone you requested, Professor.
Good. Then we may begin your lesson. You can conjure more than potions and herbology tables. Conjuration can be used to decorate this space to your liking. Why don't you try it on the walls and floor? Good work. Shall we move on?
I've conjured everything I can. What's next, Professor?
I think you're ready to take on alteration. The altering spell will allow you to customize any conjured item. You can change the colors, patterns, and styles of your furniture to suit your taste. Let's get started, shall we? Watch closely as I demonstrate how to perform the altering spell. Just aim your wand at any conjured item and perform the... spell to customize it. done. Now, for something a little more advanced. You can use the altering spells on the room's architecture. Try these new designs on the floor or balcony. From a bit of ambiance, don't you think? Deke, would you mind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. Professor Weasley showed Deke this bit of magic some years ago. Deke thinks you'll enjoy it. Come and talk to Deke when you're ready.
Professor Weasley said I should ask you about changing the room's ambiance.
Of course. What sort of overall look most appeals to you?
I'd like the room to feel mysterious and eerie, as if I'm in the Forbidden Forest, surrounded by shadows.
Oh, sounds perfect.
Quite a difference. Of course, you needn't keep this style if you don't like it. You can always ask Deke to change it back. Now you have learnt a good bit about alteration.
Thank you, Professor. The room is full of possibilities.
Indeed. No matter how much time I spend here, the room always manages to surprise me. Even bigger space.
How did that happen?
The room equips itself to your needs. It must have sensed that you needed more space to practice spellcasting. If you'd like to customize the space further, you can use these spellcrafts. You'll find more of them both inside and outside the school.
Thank you, Professor. I shall keep an eye out.
Good. I'll leave you to it. This is your space now. Use it wisely.
Wonderful.
Yeah.